Good morning friends, I welcome all of you to joining me in this session. So today our session is QRMP scheme which is recently launched by the central government of India. The main purpose to implement this scheme to rationalize or simplify the return submission process, especially for the small taxpayers. So what with the agenda today, we will discuss in the next slide. Without wasting any time, let's discuss this topic. Slide number 2. So today agenda I covered into 4 different topics. First of all, introduction. Here we will discuss about that what is the QRMP scheme, some slight information, brief description about the scheme. In next topic, we'll discuss about who can take the benefit of QRMP scheme, means what are those person who can avail the benefit of this scheme. Okay. Third topic, we will discuss about the timing to of the QRMP scheme, means what should be the period when a registered person or a taxpayer can avail the benefit of this scheme, like maybe is it in the beginning of the year, financial year, middle of the financial year, or at the end of the financial of the previous year. So we will discuss this. Last topic, we will discuss about the method of payment of tax, means under this scheme what should be the procedure to make the payment of the tax, what are those items we have to include, this thing we will discuss. In introduction section, so first of all we have to understand what is QRMP stands for. So QRMP stands for the quarterly return and monthly payment. In existing system, what we have to do, we have to pay tax monthly if there is a tax liability by filling the detail in GSTR 3B and then create a challan and make the payment. But in this scheme, what we have to do, you have to make the payment monthly if there is a tax liability, but you don't need to submit GSTR 3B. For GSTR 3B, you have to go in the last month of the quarter, you have to file the GSTR 3B detail and make the payment accordingly during the month and last 2 months if there is any different variations from the payment you made earlier. Okay, this scheme is applicable from 1st of January 2021 and only a registered person can avail the benefit of this scheme. Okay. Then last is IFF facilities they are providing you, means IFF facilities, invoice furnishing facility. You can prepare an invoice through the system which will show as a input credit to your customer's GST portal accounts. Okay. Topic number 2, who can avail the benefit of this scheme? So basically, as I mentioned earlier, that this scheme is available only for registered person who are registered under the GST Act. This scheme only applicable for those registered person whose aggregate annual aggregate turnover, in short term you have seen AATO, annual aggregate turnover is less than 5 crore rupees in previous year, or if during the financial year a registered person's turnover crosses more than 5 crore rupees, then he has to opt out from this scheme. This scheme is only available as a GSTN wise, means it means that if same pen holder have more than 2 GST numbers, more than 1 GST numbers, and in one GST number there is a turnover more than 5 crore, but in other GST number it is less than 5 crore, so you may choose this scheme. For one GST, you may to pay the tax as normally existing, as per the normal existing systems. Okay. Second thing here, what is the aggregate turnover? So as per the GST, aggregate turnover means all taxable supplies, exempted supplies, export supplies, or interstate supply, but excluding those supplies which are taxable under the reverse charge mechanism. You have to exclude those supplies. So it forms the aggregate annual aggregate turnover. Okay, there is one question asked by the viewers that what happened if he is a newly registered person or he is newly registered under composition scheme. So in both cases, this option is also available for them. Okay, not for existing taxpayer also, for newly registered taxpayer also. Slide number 3, best timing to opt QRMP scheme. So basically QRMP scheme option is available throughout the year. You may choose at the beginning, middle, or at the end of the year. And you may make the choice vice versa. Means changes for if you are availing the benefit of QRM pay scheme and you want to move to the normal scheme, so you may do so. If you are in a normal existing system and you want to go to the QRM pay scheme, so you may also go with that. For port, for in two option, if your annual aggregate turnover is less than 5 crore rupees, and if it is the registered choice that he wants to choose, what option is best suited for you. Suppose you are a newly registered person and you don't have a sale, you know that my business will not be run for next 6 months, so you may avail the benefit of QRM pay scheme, okay. But if you are if you know that I will generate a sale regularly during the month, so you may go with the normal scheme, okay. It is my personal view only. Initial registered person shall be migrated as initially. So now what is going, if you are going to submit a November return or December return, you will see it will options. I will show you where it will, by default it is selected a QRM as selected you as a QRM pay scheme. If you want to, you don't want to avail this benefit, so you have to make the changes and give your approval also. I will show you how. Registered person can opt out of QRM pay. This option is available for only from 5th of December 2020 to 21st January 2021. Okay, means you want to exist in you want to follow the existing system, or you just want to avail the benefit of QRM pay scheme. Topic number 4, last topic, method of payment of tax in the scheme. So as I mentioned earlier, every quarter you have to make the assessment of your liability monthly basis. What you have to do, suppose in a month you have generated sales 100 rupees and you have input tax credit 20 rupees. So what is the net tax liability? That is 80 rupees. So you have to pay 80 rupees on provisional basis and monthly basis. Okay. If suppose next month you have to follow the same pattern, in third month suppose it happened that one of the invoice return, there is a sales return, so make the adjustment your liability in the last month when you are going to file the GSTR 3B month. Okay, this payment you have to make to the challan by directly create a challan. There is one option that monthly payment for quarterly taxpayer, you have to choose that option while you are creating the challans. Okay, after that, if suppose there is a no sales or no tax liability arises during the month, so there is no need to deposit any money in that. Okay, first two tax paid first 2 months would be adjusted with the last month if there is any reduction in the tax liabilities. But one thing is, remember that if you have whatever tax you paid during these 2 months, you can't be used this money for any other purpose. Means what? Means this, that suppose you have paid some money, you have created a challan for first 2 months, but suddenly there is one, you notice that I take a wrong GST, wrong input credit in last year. While you are filing this annual return, you just want to file DRC3 form, so you cannot adjust this amount with your DRC3 amount. You have to make the separate payment for that. Okay guys, now you can see that how can we avail this benefit of this scheme. So if you have a GST, you just log into your GST portal and go to the service section, then go to sub return section. So here you can see opt in for quarterly returns. Click it here and select the year, basically for next year, and he will ask you the options. Whatever the option do you want to choose, you may choose, and this will the filing of return due date would be reflected accordingly. Suppose in quarterly 13th of April 24 GSTR 3B1, and for monthly there is a due date. So this is the option. You have to save and continue to return dashboard. This is all thing, all of to all this is the all you have to do. Okay. So thank you friend, this is all about our QRMP scheme session. I hope you enjoy this session and it is also help you to understand the concept of QRMP scheme. We'll meet again with more interesting videos. Till then, thank you so much. Take care.